My name is Michael Johnson. I'm the acting assistant principal this year. And on behalf of Mr. Bellamo and our entire Fox family, welcome back if you've come here before. And to our new friends, welcome. Thank you to those who could not be here today. And the success of our students has truly taken the efforts of many wonderful people. I want to give a huge thanks to our fifth grade planning committee for our completion. Let's give them a round of applause. A thank you to our wonderful Fox PTO. And of course, our amazing fifth grade teachers. Let's give them a round of applause. Father, I truly understand the struggles our parents and our families have endured these past few years. With remote learning and hybrid learning and back to normal in-person school, despite our challenges, our students have remained resilient. They've truly emulated the very definition of what it means to persevere. Although I feel bad for the obstacles our students have faced these past few years, I know they've demonstrated their strength through every step. Their fighting spirit kept them smiling, it kept them laughing, and kept them ready to learn. And through it all, they have a growth mindset. People often say, kids are different today. And you know what? Those people are right. Kids today are doing things we never thought possible. Our kids have challenges and experience that some of us may have never endured as a child. Take a look at technology. For example, when you don't understand it, who do you ask? Your kids. Our fifth grade Fox students will be a part of many advancements and careers in one day that don't even exist today. Kids today are capable of wonderful things. They have many ideas. And kids today are building things and they're creating things. And I know that our Fox students are going to surpass what we can only dream for them. So right now, I would like to introduce our principal, Mr. Frank Bellamo.
Thank you for being here today. Truly couldn't ask for a better Fox family with you parents and all of our team here at Fox. Tonight we have many great things and celebration of your children, your fifth graders who are soon to be sixth graders. At this time, we are going to bring in our fifth grade students.
Fix this.
Students, Ms. Gianna DeFada, Fabian Ferry, Michaela Sheena to sing the Star Spangled Banner. So here's our flag. If we could all please stand.
Was so proudly we hailed and
to remember one principle, and that's to love. More so than anything is just to learn to love one another. And Abraham, his parents can't hear. And they've raised him an amazing way. He's an amazing young man. And so since we were in a lockdown, we really couldn't sing because, you know, everybody had masks and everything was in and out, wherever. We learned sign language for I Believe I Can Fly. And his dad is coming in right now. And this is your moment to shine, Abraham. So rather than sing the lyrics, the students are going to sign the lyrics so that everybody can understand what we're doing. to our exciting Fox fifth grade seated in front of us tonight. We are immeasurably proud of you, each and every one of you. There were those of you who seemed to have wings. You just soared over the obstacles and challenges that crossed your path, and it's a wonderful gift, and one that never fails to amaze me. You believed you could fly. And although not everyone may have felt they had wings that saw them soaring over obstacles confronted by 2 years of lockdown, each and every one of you have a heart that motivated you to move forward, bit by bit, every day, one day at a time. And yes, you all got there. You all achieved your goals. Slowly, little by little, step by step, day by day, your course was steadfast. And despite some setbacks, you never lost sight of your goals. I can only applaud and say bravo, brava, bravissimo. To that kind of perseverance and determination, remember J.S. Bach, walking 30 miles to see the organist, J.A. Rankin? Remember? Okay, COVID, the COVID quavers. I love J.A. Rankin, I love J.A. Okay. Your purposeful resolve to get where you needed to be was demonstrated day after day. Even when it may not always have been very easy, well done, you did it. Whether it be academic, cultural, sporting, student council, clubs, service squad, Lego robotics, science Olympiad, piano club, running club, whatever it was that you chose, you made them your own. We are indeed very proud of you. And through it all, I hope you learned one of the most important things we could have ever told you through positivity projects and announcements or face-to-face. Do unto others as you would have them do unto you. Treat one another with love and with respect. For the more you practice this, the more you will receive it. And my wish for all of you, while you're achieving your goals and your dreams as young adults and beyond, is that you always remember to give love and respect. Because that's what I want for you most, is to receive love and respect all your lives. Thank you so much. You're amazing. And now, Mrs. Alfonsi, student speech.
Ceremony. You did it. Congrats. This year has been amazing, especially with all the fun things we did. But it's not just the events that made all these years so memorable. It's our teachers, friends, and family who helped us get here in the first place. Like, I have many memories from Fox. For instance, my first day of school in kindergarten. Long story short, gave my mom a heart attack when I didn't go home because I was on a different bus. Or when Miss Smith introduced me to piano and told me I should take private lessons. And when we were quarantining, that was a big change for us. We even made history being the first kids to be quarantining online. It was hard, but we did it. Our memories, friends, and teachers will stick with us for a long time, and it will help to achieve goals in middle school and keep making Fox proud. Thank you very much.
Alpine. I'm here to represent this year's fifth grade safety patrol members. The life of a safety patrol member. As most of you found out, it is not an easy job. It had its good days and some bad days as well. Think back to some of those things that you went through. Whether it was too cold to go out and you couldn't get the flag box open because it was frozen shut for days, wet, you got soaked in the rain, even though there's ponchos in the safety room. Well, you all thought it would be more fun to play in the rain. Too windy, and it took four of us to keep the flag from blowing away and getting it off the pole. And the time when someone ran over all the safety sticks with their car in that parking lot. Enough said about that parking lot. What I am proud of, though, is that through all these things you have learned. You learned how to work together as a team. You learned about patience and kindness to your teammates, to your classmates, to the students by getting them to school safely. You learned how to keep your cool even when others would not listen to you. You learned about responsibilities and the importance of showing up to do your job every day, whether you felt like it or not. All of these things are going to help you along the way as you go through middle school, high school, and throughout your life. I'm proud of the work you did as Safety Patrol members. I hope that you had fun and can take away some great memories of working together to keep our students safe to and from school every day. As I call your name, please stand and represent our Safety Patrol. Madison Barrett, Victor Bunyan, Grayson Conley, Ryan Red Gardner, Kay Juice Yusevich, Alexa Kellum, Vito Odom, Eric Schwartfeger, Lucas Schimmett. Congratulations.
This is my first year organizing the wonderful students who make up our student council. I'm sorry, our service squad. I'm not student council. We do this all the time. Ms. Sarabella and I, sorry. Tonight we will recognize our 24 fifth grade service squad students. But first, I would like to take a minute to acknowledge Mr. Skelsey. Mr. Skelsey preceded me in doing this job for 15 years, and he really did a wonderful job. His commitment to the students of Fox should not go unnoticed. I would like to take a minute to recognize the dedication that made our service squad what it is today. Will you please stand, Mr. Skelsey, so we can all give you a hand? Thank you, Mr. Skelsey. I would like to now introduce Fabian Ferry, who is a fifth grader that will give a little bit more information about our service squad and tell you what kind of jobs they do. You're good.
Hello, everybody. My name is Fabian Ferry, and I'm a member of the Fox Elementary Service Squad. Students on service squad work every day before and after school, helping teachers and other staff members. We do jobs like stacking and unstacking chairs, walking kids to their bus, tidying up classrooms, passing out papers, and helping with recycling. I am really lucky to work with Ms. D, our head custodian, and Ms. Deek, one of our second grade teachers. I help Ms. D in the morning in the kitchen. I deliver copy paper, I deliver milk cards for breakfast, and I take out the garbage. I help Ms. Deek after school too. I wipe down tables and desks, I sharpen pencils, I clean the floor, and I stack chairs. I like doing these jobs because I'm not only helping Ms. D and Ms. Deek, but I'm helping all the staff and students at the Fox. At this time, Ms. Morrell will announce the fifth grade student squad members.
For a wonderful year and doing such a great job for all the staff at Fox. When I call your name, please stand and face your parents. Noah Baez, Caitlin Davis, Gianna DeFada, Willow Durkee, Fabian Ferry, Michaela Gonzalez, Jackson Jawinski, Autumn Karpinski, Elise McAvoy, Courtney Metcalf, Riley Moses, Hannah Oraha, Jacqueline Orlowski, Logan Porter, Miranda Powell, Latalia Rodriguez, Haley Ross, Amela Savick, Raymond Seidlin-Benny, Taylor Schmidt, Michaela Sheena, Kylie Thomas, Brindley Warren, and Anaya Word. Thank you very much, boys and girls. Mrs. Alfonsi will now talk about Science Olympiad.
Science Olympiad is a competition for elementary school students interested in learning more about science. Students spend months studying and practicing for 2 to 3 events from a list of 17, like anatomy, water rockets, crash cart expert. They compete against students at other schools who have also studied and practiced. Our Fox team took third place in the district competition and 9th place at the county competition. Please stand when you hear your name. Fifth grade competitors were Eric Schwartfigure, Valentina Grisi, Graziella Grisi, Caitlin Davis, Taylor Schmidt, Alexia Stan, Victor Bumyai, Malaya De La Santo, and Madison Barrett.
We are here to introduce the 5th grade LEGO Robotics team members.
LEGO Robotics is for 5th grade students who wish to learn about coding and computer science. Students start in November and spend several months working on their robots. We have 4 events: Sumo, Eliminator, Maze, and Shootout.
We compete against each other. Other elementary school in our districts. Our team worked very hard together.
Please stand when your name is called. Our 5th grade competitors were Brianna Alderson, Ergen Bugarotzi, Autumn Karpinski, Natalia Rodriguez, and Jackson Wolk.
The rest are Isaac Bauman, Gianna Tafada, Zayara King, Amal Seidbeck, Zachary Heights.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Mrs. Sarvello, and I have the privilege of working with the Fox Elementary Student Council. I'm going to introduce 2 lovely ladies that helped me this year in co-president positions, Caitlin Davis and Taylor Schmidt.
Assist our school in making it a better place. This year, The student council had over 70 members from first grade to fifth grade.
Fox School Council promotes school spirit and the service projects for our school, community, county, and the world. This year, we participated in School Spirit Days, collected food for the Macomb County Food Drive, promoted a school-wide kindness campaign, made pet toys for Macomb Humane Society, and even gave tours to incoming kindergarten students and families.
We would like to introduce the fifth grade student council members. When we call your name, can you please stand up? Kate Yusevich, Mayla DeSantos, Gianna DeFara, Kayomi Coleman, Chloe Fairley, Brianna Alderson. Ryan Barber.
Ryan Gardner, Faith Koo, Sarah Miller, Dana Neal, Alexa Cullo, and Aragon Bullrich. There are a bunch more that I like bravery, enthusiasm, and much more, but I'm stuck loving humor. So I'm going to share a few humor stories from our years at Fox. Now let's all rewind this teensy-winsy bit and get to our first day of school. All right, so I was pretty sassy when I was little. All right, maybe a little bit now too, but let's not get distracted. Alright, so it was my first day of school, and you know, everyone's parents came for the first day. Now, I don't know if it's for everybody, but it was for my class, and it was all going well, me playing with toys, having a good time, and all of a sudden, trust me, I'm not even surprised, I tell my parents, leave. Go away. I don't need you here. And then I kept whining every 2 minutes, and then I hear my parents say, I don't know. Can we leave? She won't stop whining. We have to figure something out. And I am, for some reason, still laughing about it to this day. I'm so sorry, Mom and Dad. One time at the field trip we went to Greenville Village, some of my friends, we aren't going to mention names today, they wanted to play on the grassy area they saw and wanted to play with the ball they found and were playing with it by passing it to each other. And one other friend threw the ball too hard and hit him right in the stomach, and all of them were laughing. He was trying to laugh too, but obviously it wasn't working out. But after a bit, he felt better and started laughing too. So you know that weird stuff like school virtually? Well, for a science lesson, our teacher put a container of sugar cubes in our packets for our lesson, and my friend didn't know and thought it was a treat, so she ate them. And obviously, I don't even know who would just eat sugar cubes like that, but anyways, a couple days later, our teacher said, "All right, guys, get your sugar cubes from your packet for today's science experiment." When my friend heard that, you could tell by her face that she was guilty. I admit that was pretty funny. Another time, a student woke up, logged in, and no one was there. He looked at the clock and realized it was 5:30 a.m. I don't know about you, but I would be cranky if I had to wake up at that time. Another time, when we were on a field trip, my friend saw a cow and called it a horse. I'm very sorry for all the farmers here. Here we are in kindergarten. So it was the morning, and Mrs. Harris put on the Count by Five song, and then we started dancing, having a good time, and all of a sudden, my own tooth flamed out of my mouth onto the carpet, like 2 or 3 feet away from me, and then I was screaming with the highest pitch in the world. I screamed, "I lost my tooth!" I ran across the room to the other side and grabbed my tooth so proudly. That's going to stay with me for a long time. And wow, that was kind of dramatic. I should enter a role for a movie. Now, here is one more story. So this happened in first grade, and it was time for bathroom breaks. Well, eventually, it was my friend's turn, and while she was in the bathroom, somebody almost opened the door. He barely opened the crack of it, and everyone was screaming and laughing at the same time. It was crazy. And I was kind of confused. I hope you enjoyed all the funny nonsense that has happened with us. Again, I thank everyone for everything they have done, because we wouldn't be here today if it weren't for you all. Thank you so much. I'm going to miss all of you.
It's going to be hard to top, but I think I can move away the kiddie stool for now. Maybe not that tall, but that's okay. Next, we have some different awards that we want to give our kids. We have wonderful kids. All of our kids here at Fox are wonderful, but we do have some special awards that we're going to give, and we're going to start off, I'm going to go off the list a little bit, and then I will have Miss Nicolay's class and Miss Wilbur's class do theirs after me. But first, we're going to start off with our presidential awards. So for our presidential awards, these awards are very tough to get. These awards are recognizing all A's, maximum 1 B, and the end of the year assessments with reading and writing must meet the standards. So these kids really had to have the best of the best with the grades. Now we're gonna say your names, and we congratulate you for a job well done. This is not easy to do, not easy at all. Eric Schwartfeger. Caitlin Davis, Courtney Metcalf, Ryan Gardner, Haley Ross, Giovanna Bukai, Alexia Stan, Alexa Kellum, Graziella Garizzi, Valentina Garizzi, Kate Yusevich, Andrew Pissarro, Logan Porter, Alex Raba, Chloe Farley, Madison Barrett, Marissa Bolas, Lucas Schimmick, Malaya De Los Santos, and Gianna DeFaro. Congratulations. All right. We have many more awards. Here we go. The next one, we have Principal's Awards. Now, these awards, you don't necessarily have to have the Presidential Award or all A's or anything like that. These are a little bit different. I wanted these a few years back because I wanted to just try to recognize some of the kids who I might see on a daily basis or throughout the week and that have always shown great character. They're very friendly, personable when they come up to me and they realize that I'm not a big mean person. But they come up to me, they'll start conversations. I might see them in the hall just treating each other with kindness, showing great character, maybe it's a sense of humor, but many different qualities in that might represent from the Positivity Project or just overall
great character that I've seen. Now, all of you kids have great character, we know that. But these are the students that I chose for the Principal's Award throughout the years of getting to know you. The first one, Myla Dow. Ibrahim Al Abdelaba. Fabian Ferry. Alexa Kellogg. Maxim Prontevic. Riley Moses. Kylie Thomas. Alexander Ilyuski. And Priya Mankel. Congratulations. All right, the next awards were chosen by teachers. We do the Positivity Project here at Fox, and each day we talk about character and how we can represent, we can demonstrate good character each day in school and out of school. And these are the names. Taylor Hall. Raven Hayes Seglin-Benny. Brianna Elderson. Michaela Gonzalez. Naomi Coleman, Aldean Tenzin, and Grayson Conley. Well done. We have Writing Achievement Awards. These were chosen by their teachers, and these are the names. Grace Cracchiolo, Priya Mangu, Naya Word, Matilda Zora, Zaira King, and Georgia Banker. Keep writing. All right, and for sportsmanship. You guys go to physical education throughout the week, you have tons of fun, and Miss McAlpine has awards for your sportsmanship because it was greatly recognized. Matilda Zora, Ryan Gardner, Jackson Jawinski, Faith Koop, Eric Schwartbeger, Brianna Elderson, Naomi Coleman, Graziella Grisi, Valentina Grisi, Logan Porter, Kate Busevich, Alex Raba, Lucas Schimmick, Grace Cracchiolo, Sophia Cracchiolo, Alexa Kello, Anahi Ruiz, Sahara Thomas, Miranda Powell, Taylor Hall, and Vito Odo.
Next, we have awards for musicianship. So students that went out of their way, they're musically talented, and we just think they're going to shine. Gianna Nefada. Antonio Smith. Madison Barrett. Jacqueline Olowski. Dalen Neal. Amy Ross. Jackson Wilbur, Michaela Sheena, Fabian Ferry, Amanda Slusser, Alexia Stan, Valentina Garisi, Graziella Garisi. Congratulations. Next, awards for outstanding artistes. Taylor Hall. Raymond Hayes Seglin-Benny. Isabella Galvan. Andrew Pascariu. Haley Ross. Zach Heights.
Aurora Militello. Congratulations. I have a few more awards. For reading achievement, Aragon Bogoretsi. Sahara Thomas. Jacqueline Orlowski. Madison Barrett. Brianna Alderson. And Lucas Schimmick. And for math achievement, Kylie Thomas. Zaira King. Miranda Powell. Kevin Freud. Joseph Reiling. And Malaya De Los Santos. And science awards for science exploration, Brianna Elderson. Gabriel Lyman. Fabian Ferry. Alexa Kello. Courtney Metcalf. And Daylon Neal. And Social Studies. Maxim Premchevic. Anahi Ruiz Gomez. Jackson Wilbur. Grayson Conley. Ben Dimash. And Naya Word. And the last of the awards for the specials categories, the Science Achievement Award in the regular classroom, the general ed classroom, Sophia Cracchiolo, Aurora Militello, Alexander Ilyeski, Jackson Wilbur, and Grayson Conley. Congratulations. Ms. Nickerman.
On behalf of myself and my fellow classmates, I would like to take this moment to express our gratitude for the less amazing 6 years many of us have had here at Fox. For our principal, Mr. Bellamo, and our assistant principal, Mr. Johnson, and of course our teachers, we cannot express enough the impact you have all made in our lives. You have not only taught us to be safe, respectful, and responsible, you have taught us to believe in ourselves and that anything is possible. For me, I would like to personally thank Ms. Molnarek, Mrs. Alfonsi, Mrs. Braun, Ms. Camp, Ms. Knoll, and of course Mrs. Wilbur and Mrs. Nicolai for everything you all have done for me throughout the years and especially making my last year here at Fox so special. For Mrs. Smith and Mrs. Alfonsi, who are retiring this year, you will both be truly missed. Shout out to Mrs. McAlpine from all the 5th grade safety patrol members. Thank you for giving us the opportunity to be a part of a team and that was able to keep all Fox students safe. Go Blue! It's been a true honor to have been on this journey with you all. I wish you all the best of luck in your future endeavors. Thank you.
All right, kids. Now, we didn't practice this part, but not everything in life can be practiced. So what we're going to do next is when we're going to call your name, and you're going to have a picture right in front with me, the photographer, me and you. We're going to be right here in front, okay? All right.
And I'm so proud to present to you the Fox Elementary class of 2022. This is my class, Ibrahim Alab Alabas. Ibrahim, come on over to Mr. Bellamo. There you go. Brianna Alderson. Marissa Bolas. Benjamin Kamage. Naomi Coleman. Malaya De Los Santos. Jana DePada. Chloe Farley. Isabella Galvan. Graziella Grisi. Valentina Grisi. Michaela Gonzalez. Kamaya Hughes. Alexander Ilyuski. Glendale Jones. Kay Yusevich. Autumn Karpinski. Priya Munku. Andrew Piscario. Logan Porter. Alex Reba. Joseph Reeling. Amala Sabek. Lucas Schimmick. Tristan Sharp. Alexia Stan. Kimora Studemeyer. Aldine Tanji. Kylie Thomas. And Anaya Word. Thank you.
Coming up and going out. We don't have the luxury of being in the first row here, so be careful on the way out and back to your seat. Aiden Bashi. Noah Baez. Lucas Becker. Aline Baudat. Isaac Bowman. Victor Bunyai. Grayson Connolly. Caitlin Davis.
Lila Dow. Kevin Freuda. Jackson Jawinski. Sierra King. Faith Koo. Courtney Metcalf. Aurora Militello. Sarah Miller. Daylon Neal. Hannah Baraja. Jacqueline Orlowski. Nevaeh Reed. Latalia Rodriguez. Haley Ross is not here today. Taylor Schmidt. Eric Schwartfeger. Michaela Sheena. Niran Smiley. Georgia Banker. Giovanna Bunchai. Brindley Warren. Jackson Wilbur. And Matilda Zorro.
Taylor Hall.
students. To our students, you are now ready to begin middle school. You will now have more opportunities available to you. You'll meet new people, you'll make new friends, and truly have the opportunities to do some wonderful things during your educational career. One thing that I hope you continue to do is have good character. Of course, grades are good, but your character is more important than any grade you will ever get in school. I always say that we want Fox students who work hard, who treat others the right way, and demonstrate a growth mindset. Because as I said before, grades are great, but your character will forever define you, not a letter grade. Hard work beats talent when talent doesn't work hard. Your effort comes from the heart and not a grade. Today we've recognized you for many different awards, but truth be told, you don't need an award to know that you're a great person, and all of you kids are great kids. You all have gifts, and some of those gifts you haven't even discovered yet. Maybe it's a musical talent. Maybe you're somebody who's a wonderful writer. Maybe you're somebody who's going to invent a new medicine to help people in the world one day. All of you are going to do great things, and you can do great things. I want to thank our Fox family for being here with us again tonight. I want to thank our parents, because without your effort and all your hard work, we couldn't do the things that we do with your kids. I want to thank our PTO and our fifth grade planning committee, because you made this event happen and you've been supporting us from day one and all year. I want to congratulate Ms. Smith and Ms. Alfonsi on their retirements. Truly wonderful, wonderful teachers. We are sad that you're leaving, but we are very happy to have had an opportunity to make the memories that we did with you. The kids will forever miss you and remember you. Together we are the Fox family. Thank you all for your dedication. Kids, I want to leave you with a few different things for tonight. Oh, I lost them because now they have treats. It's all right. It's all right. When you go to middle school and high school, here's a couple things to remember. You ready, kids? I know there's chocolate right there. All right, number one, do your best each day. And whatever you do, do your best. Second, do your best to make people smile every day. Make people laugh, make people smile. Do it at the right time. You don't want to get in trouble in class. Make good choices. You're going to meet many different people in middle school and high school. Make sure the choices you are making are the right choices. They're respectful and responsible choices. So there's a quote that I think is a really neat quote, and I'm going to read it to you. Do not go where the path may lead. Go instead where there is no path and leave a trail. All of you have an opportunity to do great things. Don't be followers, be leaders. You guys have many talents, many gifts, and many great days ahead of you. Make great choices. Be better today than you were yesterday, and be better tomorrow than you were today. We love you forever. You are always our Fox family. Before we go, our fifth grade planning committee would like to present the kids with their treats, because I know you guys want them. And I know that the Sheena family had brought some flowers today for Ms. Smith. You may present her with those. Michaela, you can do that. You can find her. Where is she? Again, we thank Ms. Smith. We thank Ms. Alfonsi for your commitment to our kids, the love you've shown them each day. It's going to be very difficult to replace Ms. Smith and Ms. Alfonsi, but we will do our best. We will do our best. But again, thank you for coming out this evening. We appreciate you. We appreciate you being a part of the Fox family. We're going to present these gifts to our kids, and then we are going to release our students, starting with Miss Wilbur's class. Miss Wilbur and Nick Lloyd's class, you have to bring them home with you. You can't leave them here. Okay? But thanks again. We love you all. Have a wonderful summer. We have school tomorrow and we have school Wednesday. They're both half days. Don't let them tell you there's no school.